So I'm going to take it home here with the final, you know, I said I'll come back and give you some insights on where we are heading for powering tomorrow's needs. And this is very interesting because some of tomorrow's needs are like literally Monday, okay? So we're going to go and work for things in Monday. So the Monday need is an industry need for compliance and verification. And we announced the OVP program this week. You know, huge response. We have end users supporting it. We have, you know, standards bodies like GSMA helping out, ETSI helping out, LF Networking, all its members. We're going to make this happen and help with interoperability and testing, and that too right in open source. So what does it mean? What it means is it's accelerated deployment. Some of the early numbers coming out is, you know, a reduction of almost 50% intervals of deployment, right, in terms of interoperability. Because you're pushing the problem ahead in the cycle. What are you doing? If you want to onboard services, and Marissa said this, right, like how do you do services and how do you take a service-centric view? That's what the operators care about. Everything below is just a box or a software, and you can see the colorful nature. Now, normally we would say colors are great, it's vibrant, it's spring is coming and all that, but in this instance, colors are bad because every color adds time, okay? A different flavor of NFVI with a different WIM, with a different NFVO, and a different VNF. Where we are trying to get to with the OVP program is align some of the profiles on NFVI, which will really expedite the, you know, 20,000 variables that go in the system when you start configuring, you know, all the things. And, you know, trust me, I have personally done it probably 4 years ago, and it's not easy. So, you know, that's one big thing. You know, we're starting to get down to a couple of VIMs integrated with the NFVI. We're going to use the building blocks of that ONAP has given us for the NFVO, as well as for the SDKs and both Heat and Tosca templates that ONAP programs have provided. And then leave the colors of VNFs as they are, meaning innovation happens, you know, not. You don't want to do, you know, different lifecycle management for a VNF, how they onboard, start, stop, log, update, restart. There's no innovation there, right? I don't want everybody to do it differently. That's kind of what we help standardize, test, automate, and script it. So this is a big program. I think we need all your support and all your members' support. Join the CVC program under LF Networking, and we will make this happen for the collective and user community. The second need for tomorrow is a unified edge, and we have issued a call for a unified edge where instead of fragmenting the IoT way of doing things, telecom way of doing edge, enterprise way of doing edge, and a cloud way of doing edge, let's come together and at least collaborate on some of the most common lifecycle management and plumbing. If we do that, we have a very simplistic view of things where, you know, you have the mobile networks through the ORAN Alliance, you have home and how home edge as a project under LF Edge is kind of bringing the lifecycle and orchestration together. You have the enterprise virtualization standardization, you have the IoT framework standardization under EdgeX Foundry. You have the telecom edge as well as some of the blueprint standardization across Acrano. And then in collaboration with the other open source projects in this, including public cloud projects, as well as consortiums on the edge, right? Specifically at CMEC, automotive edge computing, and then of course IIC, you can actually come up with a framework, and we have seen a very successful collaboration you know, happen in LF Networking, it's happening in LF Edge, and that's kind of what is a big thing going on this year, okay? So that's kind of the second need. I would say the third need for tomorrow is what Dan talked about, which is how do you take the best principles of cloud native and help networking, you know, a migration, do a hybrid approach, you know, depending on where you're coming from. So what we have done here, and I think Dan talked about it a little bit, is, you know, virtual machines and containers will exist for quite some time. And there will be hybrid instances, there will be only VMs, there will be portions where there will be only containers. The majority of the use case is an and. And so we are collaborating with both OpenStack and Kubernetes to enable these technologies to come and give us that value of what I call efficiency, portability, and simplicity. And there's a lot of work going on in several working groups, you know, within ONAP, within OPNFV, within Edge, and then within CNCF and Kubernetes as well. So please join that as well. And this is, again, a hot topic for 2019. And sort of the last thing that I want to bring out for tomorrow is blockchain for telecom. This is no longer a marketing thing, right? It was last year. But this year, it's real. And when I say it's real, meaning clever people are coming together and figuring out what specific use cases are important for telecom using blockchain technology. So we're collaborating with our foundation's Hyperledger program, and we're looking at these six use cases for blockchain. There is a special interest group that Hyperledger has launched that will allow these collaboration to happen, whether it's in use cases of 5G implementation. So again, remember, for those of you who are not familiar with blockchain, just think of trust, identity, and security as kind of our anywhere there is trust, right? Whether it's AAA or roaming or things that we are used to in our networking world. This can be done with full authentication, right? So that is where we're going to start collaborating in blockchain and telecom. So these are kind of the big ticket items that are tomorrow's needs for the community, and we welcome you to sort of come back and join these. And so to wrap, what are the key takeaways, right? The one thing I found which was very interesting is a lot of people said the same thing. Now, I know it may sound a little boring and repetitive in the audience, but to me, that's a huge win for us as a community. Because what is happening is people are aligned. People are saying, yes, this is the path. And I hate to break it to the press here, there's not a lot to write. There is no stories to make us fight. So sorry about that, but it is good for the industry. So for a change, write something positive, right? I mean, not that you don't, but I'm just kidding. But here's the vision. I put this chart up 3 ONSs ago, and I said, what would be a world, where we can have these services on the top, connect with infrastructure, and everything in the middle, the plumbing, is automated. And we've come a long way, right? Using these foundations, these open source organizations, we have hit cloud automation, telecom network automation, edge automation. There's a lot of detail behind how these projects and how these technologies collaborate, but this is a great, great start to the collaboration. And so I call 2019 the year of open collaboration, okay? And I started the session by saying, that's your fourth step in the progression. And, we are really excited about this, right? Because there's technology convergence and collaboration. We're no longer talking about 5G in isolation or networking in isolation. We're no longer talking about AI and ML in isolation. SDN and NFV is a building block for so many things today, right? We don't even give it justice, right? I mean, I know people don't like to talk about technologies that are 5-year-old, but they are in networks today. It's a given, right? Edge, blockchain, cloud native. There is huge technology convergence and collaboration that is happening, okay? So we're really excited about that. The thing that I'm sure you took away from this conference is industries are now interdependent on each other. Let that sink in for a moment, okay? The telecom industry, the cloud industry, the enterprise, and take any enterprise, automotive, energy, insurance, banking, payments, supply chain, they're all interdependent. There's no longer, you give me a pipe and I'm good with it, or I'll put everything in the cloud and I'm done, right? There is interdependence. And that's what's driving this collaboration in the open source community. And we have been very fortunate to be the catalyst for collaboration, right, in the Linux Foundation and in open source in general. So that is, I think, a big change, and I'm really excited about that. The third thing that I would like is, once the first two happen, there is still a need for innovation and for vertical specific solutions. So there'll be some that's happening in open source, but majority of the customization, majority of the reference solutions, whether it's autonomous driving, whether it's telecom, whether it's service automation, real-time transactions, microservice price. I mean, there's definitely an industry slant there, but they don't have to do it all. The insurance industry does not have to do everything, because now there's technology and industries have collaborated and figured out where they can only focus on what they're good at, which is the front office, which is what their customers and their use cases are. So I think, in my mind, these are my takeaways, and I'm really excited that, you know, we have come a long way as an industry, and you know, just to celebrate the success, I think we have a very, very short you know, video that we can play to just show the success. So just roll it on very quickly. Go. So again, a big thank you to the press and analysts. They don't get enough credit. So, you know, I mean, they're very smart and they ask very tough questions, but they are generally right. So again, a big thank you, and thank you to all. I would say the next big event we will all meet, save the date, is ONS Europe, September 23rd to 25th in Belgium. We had our first ONSEU in last year, and it was a huge success. We're going to see you there. And the last day of sessions will go on. So thank you all for coming and making this a big success. Thank you.